That's a theme from Taxi Driver. Night piece for saxophone and orchestra. Film music by Bernard Herrmann from the City of Prague Philharmonic Orchestra. That's good luck on Spotify. Anyway, I have to apologize personally to my entire audience because when I was growing up, I procrastinated a lot. I didn't do my homework till the last minute, didn't do projects, and I thought having this job and this career, you know, having so much to do, so many piles of things, that I would sort of have organized myself into a nice straight line and I'd be able to get things done. Well, when I bought these speakers, it was a while ago, and I bought a couple other speakers that compete with them, and we're going to sort of mini review all of them. Just get it over with. I don't want to waste your guys' time with 4 days worth of videos and then also sound demos. So we're going to blurt this out. And I just wanted to apologize again. I'm going to keep saying I apologize because I bought these speakers on Amazon. 4.5 stars, 2,400 reviews. And I'm pretty sure it had a lot less reviews when I bought them because I didn't realize this, but on the Ides of March, 2017, that's when I bought these. And I'm going to be truly honest with you. I bought them. I said, okay, good. I'll save this review for later. And I didn't touch them for a year. And then I hooked them up, did the sound demo a couple months back, demoed all these things, used them, and went, all right, I'll get to the reviews later. And then I had to get back to headphones or IEMs or DACs or RMAP was coming or some reason I put them back into storage. And now, January 2020, almost 3 years later, it's time to tell you how amazing they are. So I probably cost a bunch of you some money. Some of you have gone out and spent money on fucking other things and this and that because I haven't completed my task. My job, I have one job. Zeos, you've got one job. Talk about shit and tell people if you like it. That's it, that's my job. That is the definition. I write that on a resume. I talk about shit and tell people if I like it. And I fucked it up. I fucked that job up. This is a pair of Rockvilles. This is a pair of Daytons. And this is a pair of pluggable. Literally pluggable. And this one, and those edifiers share a common thread that they are the cheapest self-powered speakers. I believe they all have Bluetooth. That was like the thing, because I was in the mood to figure out how to get a cheap Alexa control going into a speaker. So I went and I found, Dayton actually sent this one to me, which is a little dirty, hold on. Yeah, you're a little dusty, because you've been living in my fucking end table for like 2 years. So the main goal, the original goal, was just to find speakers that would be decent enough if you put an Echo, and this wasn't even invented, this particular little one, when these first came out. So I'm just going to put that there. And so Dayton has sent me these. I bought the pluggables, I bought the Rockvilles, and I bought the edifiers. And I'm just going to talk specifically about the edifiers and how they sound, because I think of the group, they might be the best. You could look at the sound demo in the description to actually judge for yourself, because I did, I think, 5 songs 3 times. One of these didn't get a sound demo. I think it might have been the Rockvilles. It's fine. That's fine. Or maybe it wasn't the Rockvilles. Maybe it was the Daytons. No, I think it was the Rockvilles. Doesn't matter. Does not matter. You know why? Because I forgot again how good these are. I fucking forgot how good $150 speaker can be, because I've been Zeosing it up. I've been Zeosing it lately. I've been, you know, headphones and amps and DACs and $2,000 speakers. And no. This is Zeos's roots. Zeos needs to get back to his roots of like, oh shit, cheap audio. And not just for headphones, for speakers. Like, these are $150 a pair. Mica RB42s, linked in the description, are also $150 a pair. And I don't think these beat RB42s. These will certainly not go as low. But these have Bluetooth built in, the amplifier built in. They have a remote control. Like, these are things that you have to spend money to improve. You got to get an 88, you got to spend another $100, at least 80, to just get those feature sets. And then these might look better in certain scenarios? Certainly certain scenarios. Certainly certain scenarios. Let's talk. Let's talk about how they actually look. Now, I've got them slightly modified with a foam block because sitting up on these tall stands, you could see that the front is angled back. You can see the side is covered with this nice piece of laminated wood with a like an actual curve to the bottom of it. Well, that's good thinking there. You can see, hold on, one of the rubber feet fell out. Let's do this. Perfect. They do come with grills, in fact. If you are a person who doesn't want to look at, and it's, let's just face it, it's busy. You look a little busy at a fire, but that's fine, because look, oh, that's quite laid back. That's clean. Angled front, slightly angled top, wooden sides. In fact, let's take this one's foam out as well. It's always nice to keep. These are from my JBL Studio 590 towers. Yep, keep those port plugs just hanging around. So we stand here in front of these speakers, $150, and they play, let's just shuffle. Okay. Wake up and take a look around. Can you smell it in the air? How you do that? It's all tweeter. What I'm hearing is all tweeter. I'm not sure if they're DSP corrected, because if we look at the plug in the back, that's four pins. Now, when it, usually you do these speakers, some of the cheaper ones, the Rockvilles are cheap, like built-wise, and the Daytons are cheap. The Daytons literally just come with, excuse that, the Daytons literally just come with speaker wire to wire between them. So you know that these two are just running signal from one to the other, and then there's a crossover built into it, or maybe there isn't for this price. They might not even just put a cap on the tweeter, and you're done. But the pluggable, this is literally the same cable the Vanitus come with four conductors, with the screw terminals. My Swans have a similar cable to this. So these speakers and those pluggables may be using full DSPs and multiple amp channels to power this, which means they're controlling the output, which means they sound this good because they're controlling every aspect. I've talked about DSP correction. I've talked about, in the Pandas, I said, well, I'm glad they didn't do DSP correction because that means it came naturally. But speakers are a little bit harder to tune, especially when you're looking at a price point of this with amps, with Bluetooth. Oh, hello. Thank you for joining. You will get the brush. See, now I can't throw this copy away. Whatever happens in this stays because Chewbacca's adorable. All right, go get into your hole. Go get into your hole. So, all right, let's look at these actual speakers. I think they honestly are strikingly pretty in their simplicity, especially with the cover on. I'm not a big cover on fan. Exposed pins. Shiny black plastic thing. This has got all the screws and labels, and this has got screws, and that's the infrared. I like them better with the covers on. In fact, that's the last you're going to see of them in this review. It's best if people are left in mystery. It's fine. What I do want you to see, hold on. Bruce Springsteen does not sound good, and I'm sorry, I love Bruce. Chewbacca, you love Bruce? We all love Bruce, bottom of our hearts. But he don't sound very good. Oh, also the fact that I have this one unplugged. That is plugged in. This one's unplugged. All right, before I go, here's the remote control for the Edifiers. Of all the remote controls, I don't know if I like this one the best or hate it the most. It is a straight line of five buttons on a shiny black. Of a shiny black. Mute, up, down, Bluetooth, and line in. Now, I'm not gonna Bluetooth to all these speakers because that would be silly, but it just pops up like everything. Like you hit Bluetooth, it blinks, it comes up on your phone, you connect, you're done. If it Bluetooths, you connect it to the Alexa Dot thing. That's a little, I forget what that one's called. The Slim, the Shark, whatever. I'll link it in the description. I'm sure that by the future, I will be smarter. And it just comes up in the list on your app, and you're done. So this is a very basic remote. It's very shiny and black plastic, and you're probably going to lose it between the cushions of your couch forever. So keep an eye on it. And it does the basic functions. You'll note there's no on off. You don't turn these speakers off. They just sit there. And if you do need to control them, if you put them on your desk, because I'm using them in my living room because, well, my desks are sort of taken up with other things. They have manual controls on them. You don't have to use this for anything. Let's look at the powered unit, and I shouldn't have strapped it to the stand. Hi, girls. Before I plug things back in, start on the back. Left speaker out, 4 pins. Main power bus. If you're turning them off, going away for the weekend, you flip it back here. You don't have to turn these off. They don't generate any heat. When they're just standing by, they're just standing by. I have these crazy, murderous SKW RCA cables, which I kind of don't recommend because they're so stiff and they kind of look like a poisonous snake. I'm just saying they do. And then they have these beautiful metal ends with these really aggressive, I'm afraid I'm gonna yank the RCA connectors out of equipment with them, which is why I don't use them. But I bought them, so I'm gonna fucking use them. Anyway, you have 2 inputs, both full of size RCA, PC in and auxiliary in. And I'm using the PC in because, and I'm also using it backwards. I have the left wire into the right and the right wire into the left because these speakers say left speaker out, and that's the right-hand side. Yes, I understand how, you know, it's lefty, loosey, righty, tighty. Anyway, since they're both at the only inputs, the only time this would be fucked up is with Bluetooth. You can't tell Bluetooth to be backwards, so your Bluetooth would play not out of phase, just reversed. But for my case, my use case, I want the powered monitor here. I have more plugs here. I have to run my fiber optic here. There's no DAC built into this. This is just a raw analog input doing whatever it's doing, possibly DSP correcting it and pooping it out to the other channel and powering it. So I'm using a JDS Labs EL DAC because I literally have like one lying around, and I'm just RCA out into this. Probably doesn't hurt to have a very good DAC powering these speakers because they sound fucking amazing. The power cord here is attached. You can't detach it. We are talking about cheap speakers. This would normally be a killer for me, but actually only these and the Rockvilles have attached power cords. So -1 points rectifier. Simplicity at work. Now let's look at the side and tell me if you remember where these are from. Oh, the 2.1 set, the S, the S350 dB, got it. On the powered monitor had controls look just like this because they were these. Some of the nicest, look at the sun, I am not fucking with you. These feel still on this $150 pair of powered monitors like some of the nicest knobs I've ever touched. The bass, the treble, the volume with input select by pushing it are just with like an ideal detent, like it stops. None of this like half turn. These are fucking gorgeous. They're recessed in the side so it's still flush, so you could lay it on that side if you felt like it. Here's your little indicator for power because there's nothing in the front. Yes. If you're using these on a desk and you put them in the correct orientation, reach the right, bass, treble. I currently have them flat. You can't adjust it with remote. And I would maybe in a room this size put the treble up just a touch, but I don't need to. On a desk, maybe you turn the treble down a touch. Bass is entirely up to you, but I warn you, don't push it too hard or it will distort. When the bass knob goes up, it goes up. This is a 6 dB blast up and down. So, I mean, I know someone who bought these for their kitchen. They're like, I love them. I put them in my kitchen. They sound way better than they should. And they sound way better than they should anywhere you put them. I'm going to put on the plug to go to the other speaker. Like, wow, that sounds a little thin. Okay. Physical layer, everybody. It's always the physical layer first. skipping ahead. Do they need a sub? Yes. Every speaker needs a sub. These are a 4-inch. RB42s could get around needing a sub. Now keep in mind, this is also deadmau5, and I expect the fucking windows to rattle out of their frames. So if I turn the bass up, and I'll uncover this one so you can see it, I'll try not to take it to distortion. Which one's bass? Bottom? All right, makes sense. Top's treble, bottom's bass, oh my God. It feels like I'm hurting the speaker. Now I have the volume, I don't think it's max. Yeah, no, there's a fine line, keeping in mind that I'm not on a desk where these would be ideal, or if you're in a kitchen and you just want to have some music playing in the background, or your bedroom, or you bought an Echo Dot, or an Alexa, or a fucking Google Home, and you're just like, you know what really sucks? The sound quality on those. And you don't feel like spending $200 on a glorified Echo Dot, which is what these are. These will be coming up soon, by the way. Those are the Studios. Sneak peek, Studios with sub. And although those are amazing too, these are more traditional, easier to buy. Hook up, just Bluetooth to this. Now, go. Get the remote, hit Bluetooth. Or you hit the button, Bluetooth. Here we go. These impress me the most with vocals, because I hooked them up, and I've been using my Ohms now for 2 months. If you notice, I haven't had a lot of speaker reviews in this channel, not of late. And that's like fourfold. Number one, I want to use my speakers that I already have. And for, I would say, a solid year, I didn't get to use my Ohms. Maybe for like a week, and then I had to get back to work. And I took a vacation. After RMAF in September, I got a couple more things out of the way, and then I was like, you know what? I'm gonna review things on the desk, small things. I want to get back to actual speakers I own. I live here, so I have to, you know, I love these. I want to use them for like extended periods of time every day. And so getting away from speaker reviews for a bit, sort of, I see comments all the time, get back to speakers. Well, here's four pairs of speakers that anyone can afford, and at least three of them are impressive. At least three. These 1700 BTs sound, fuck. Like, I don't believe for $150 you could do better. In any form factor, self-powered. Stop. Then we walk over here, and you're looking at it going, oh, look at those. And honestly, they're Rockvilles. And the biggest thing that I was told about Rockvilles is they catch fire. Hey, did you know Rockvilles catch fire? Oh, really? So I bought their speaker stands, and that's fine, because speaker stands are inert and tend to not catch fire spontaneously. But after I heard that, I sort of put these Rockvilles, which I think the HD5s, yeah, on like a hold pattern, because I'm not really into fire. Like, I like fire, but not more than like a normal person. And they are the slightly bigger unit, and they have the same slanted fascia as the Edifiers. They're basically trying to be the Edifiers, but the problem is Rockville isn't Edifier. Rockville is Rockville. There's like glue on the driver still. So Rockville's Rockville. These don't sound bad. They actually, with the grills on, they have the see-through grills like the Big Daddy Edifiers do, and I respect them for getting that look going. But you can see this is just like a piece of, like, and then we have the connection from the other two speaker. This is literally the weirdest, like, coaxial attached. This little dinky wire plugs into here. Where is it? So there, output to right speaker. So now this actually has the powered speaker on the left. And then you have an attached wire. And then here in the port, you see I have shoved the attached power cord, which those have. So, you know, at this price range, we're sort of giving that a pass. Whatever. USB, I believe that's just power. Auxiliary 1, 3.5. Auxiliary 2, 3.5. Coaxial digital in, optical in. Optical in. I gave a shit about these because optical in means soundbars can go fuck themselves.com. Now, with that current setup in front, you could absolutely hook it up to your television. You just need a cheap DAC. In fact, I'm going to link the Fio D3 in the description. It's a very small, like $25, just USB powered, optical in, RCA out DAC. You're done. You buy that, you buy some short RCAs, I'll link those too. ZLS in the future is gonna have a fun time linking things. I'll try to break them down as evenly as possible. But you can put any of these, you can put any speaker with a remote control, in your living room. Because every TV, if you are a normal person and you just have your TV hooked up, no matter what it's hooked up to, if it's the thing currently playing sound, and maybe it's a smart TV and you do your Amazon streaming from it or Netflix from your TV, there's a fiber optic output on almost every television that comes out of your TV and says, what do you want to plug into? The problem is that fiber optic output has no volume control. It just is. If you're watching House of Cards, seasons 1 through 5, because they're the only ones that count, or was it 1 through 4? What do they fire? What's his name? And they're the only ones that count, and you plug it into a speaker, or you plug it into a DAC, in this case it would be a DAC, that DAC's gonna have full volume. It's full volume. So you need a remote control. This is what makes these speakers special. This is why I bought these speakers. Because the remote control means you don't have to limit the incoming volume. And the Rockville's no different. It's got an absolute shit way of connecting left and right. Attach cable that I understand why fires start. This is horrible. It does have a nice grill though. If you like compare it to this Dayton that we're about to look at. Like that is actually, that is rather nice. They know where to spend their money, Rockville. I'll give them that. No one gives a fuck about the wire in the back. No one gives a fuck about how you're connecting the speakers together. But that grill, that shit's classy. So, interesting way to control it. They give you a source selector push and a volume knob on top. Obviously the other speaker doesn't have it. I put the passive speakers on the bottom, the active speakers on top, so we could actually look at them. So it's literally like, oh, by the way, these weigh a hilariously light amount. Like, holy shit, are they made out of styrofoam? Yeah, I understand why these catch fire. They'll be in a yard sale, by the way. I advise the person who bids on these in the yard sale, which is accessible through any of my supporter means, either Subscribestar or Patreon, to put them in a place where fire doesn't really matter. Or if you want to bid on them for $23 and you win, bash them with a hammer for all I care. All I know is they had enough stuff in the back and they looked impressive enough. And honestly, they don't sound terrible. I think these might be the ones I don't have a sound demo of. I can't remember how many months ago I did the sound demos and it was... Whatever, happy bidding. They're done. They're the cheapest motherfucking speakers in the motherfucking earth. I'm amazed they make sound decent enough for me to even put them on this table. Moving over. Dayton. Now, Dayton sent me these. Dayton sent me a whole bunch of speakers back in the day. And this side is just a speaker. This is just a speaker with a little tiny port where they can take a regular speaker and then make it actually functionable is here. Four buttons on top, play, pause, up, down, and mode, which switches between inputs. Little LED light. If we actually look at the speaker though, goddamn, look at that surround on that 4-inch. Because I mean, that's a slightly bigger speaker, but look at that surround. These things kick. They're rear ported, it's a small port, but it's Dayton. Here's the thing, this is Dayton audio. Edifier is great. But Dayton, like, literally makes half the drivers in the fucking world. So they put these monster surround drivers on. The same tweeter we get in the MB42. Not the RB42, the MB42. So they make a thicker surrounded MB42, essentially. Then they give you this little back panel, which is, like, I can't even describe the ease of this. On... one auxiliary input, the wiring for the left to right channel, which they give you here. They give you this wire for. As you can see, I did not bother unwrapping it. So you could have fun. You could unscrew this, put the wire in, screw it down, or you can buy a regular speaker cable with bananas, although that would cost you more then the whole thing. It comes with this power brick for your DC in, and this is what, 18 volt, 2 amps? So it's got this ugly power brick that you plug into the thing, and honestly, it sounds fucking good. I don't have these speakers up here because any of them sound bad. If they sounded bad, I just wouldn't even mention it. I'd just be like, eh, and I've returned them. Fuck. I'm through. This is why I postponed this for 3 years. Because speakers like this exist, which are certainly not as pretty. Even with the grill on, it's not as pretty. The remote control, well, I should talk about the remote control for the Rockville for a second, is, well, presets 1 through 6. I don't even know what those do. I don't even remember what they do. But they do have Bluetooth, auxiliary, and Wi-Fi, which I don't know what Wi-Fi... Wi-Fi is something weird that Dayton's trying to pull off. They have like a Wi-Fi connect system. Power mute, up, down, next track, last track for controlling Bluetooth. They're not a bad choice. They just ugly. And they'll do lower extension than the Edifiers. But they're rear ported. So if you're thinking about it on your desk, this makes it a little bit harder to do placement. You got to keep it like, I'd say 8 inches off a wall. And that's a lot if you're on a desk against a wall. You can't put it there and you got to put it there. You're fucking your whole desk up. But they're probably, I want to say second best, but it hurts. Go back real quick for the Rockville. Rockville actually spent some money on their remote control too. Because the Edifier remote looks like a shiny little black thing that you're going to lose. This is substantial. You got up, down, mute. You got bass and treble controls on the remote. You have EQ selections for music, movie, news, and 3D. You got the Bluetooth USB control. Oh, it is USB control. I totally fucking forgot. So that USB will take a stick. And then you can control the USB stick with stop, play, pause, next track, last track. Then you have Bluetooth pair, reset, input, and standby. So and it takes like AAA batteries. That's great. This is like a little tiny cell battery. It's got 6 presets, which frankly, I don't remember what they do. They're not labeled very well. And you still sound good. And then finally, pluggable. You heard it at a fire. You definitely heard it Dayton. Rockville, eh. Ain't fucking nobody heard a pluggable. And neither did I. But, and I didn't look up the number of ratings or it's even sold anymore. But let me take you on a tour of this. That is a Kevlar driver. That is officially the biggest soft dome of any of these speakers. Huh. In a waveguide, and the speaker is actually recessed into a waveguide. That is the biggest port of the whole table, I think. Hold on, I'm sorry, the Edifiers definitely have the port beat. But it's goddamn big for a 4-inch. It's not the prettiest unit. They do hide all the screws, though. None of these other ones hide the screws. They don't have a cover. That's where this is the only place these differ. They don't give you the option to cover it if you want to. But they took that into account. There's no exposed screws except for these 4 around the fascia, which probably puts this entire fascia over all the other screws, but that's fine. Pluggable with a USB because you can plug them. They're also like volumetrically larger than all of these speakers except for, I think you're a little bigger. But you're a bigger driver, so that would make sense. Auxiliary input, optical input. That's it. Power plug here, built in, no adapters, power switch, and there is where you plug in the fucking Vanatoo style 4-pin that goes from left to right. And this is the left speaker, so that means this powered one is the right speaker. And your controls are here on top, just like the Dayton, only, well, nicer. You got 5 LEDs showing you Bluetooth, auxiliary, optical, bass, and treble adjustments. Volume, pairing, input mode. Huh. These sound amazing. I'm tempted to say these sound better than the Daytons, but they don't go as low, but that soft dome, you're adding like a 1/4 inch to that soft dome from this little tiny thing that can cover, but to like this, that's a That's a big fucking Fluence SX6 size soft dome. Here's your infrared receiver right here. They look like junk speakers. And I bought them because the ratings were high. And I'm like, all right, I'll do it. Oh, by the way, near field communication, in case you want to pair with something, boom, put it on top. None of these other ones have an NFC. So somehow these pluggables, which pluggables like, fuck, I promise you they don't sound bad. They don't look the part for how they sound. I mean, they got a Kevlar driver. They got a beautiful big soft dome. They just look, they're the most boring. Even the Daytons have like an angle to the like the front and side. They're trying to be like fashionable. These are obviously trying to be fashionable, but are made out of like old cereal boxes. The Edifiers do the best job of combining fashion and structure. Like this is still dense and hard and they know what they're doing. These pluggables came out of nowhere. Out of fucking nowhere. They hook up with that wire. They hook straight in. They'd probably be one of the neatest installations. I mean, that's a fucking mess. This requires you to use real speaker wires and only has a 3.5 millimeter. This, you could do RCA or fiber optic, which means you can go straight from your TV into these. Hook them up together. The only problem this has, everything's got an Achilles heel in this fucking day, is this is the remote. Power, mute, input, pairing, reset, volume up, volume down, play, pause, next track, last track, treble and bass controls on the remote. But the remote split in half like the first day I got it. Like it just fell in half. So I mean, did I do that? Did I break it? It's very possible. I'm sure if they were all breaking, there'd be terrible reviews on this. And there weren't when I bought it. So you can see one of the clips snapped off and just fell on my floor. If this doesn't happen to you, and it is one of those rubberized remotes, which means it's been here for 3 years and starting to get a little bit tacky, and that's without me touching it. Okay, we're just gonna put you down. I don't hate that remote. I hate that it broke. I don't hate this remote. I certainly don't hate that remote. That one, because if you get one of these and you decide to put it in your living room, this is what you're controlling your volume with. Unless you have a learning remote, something by Logitech, or I don't actually know who else puts out learning remotes. Chewbacca. She's not even listening. So you would have to deal with this. This would be your daily. This is volume up, honey. Volume down. There's little rubber buttons. And it's like, I think what I'm trying to say with this whole video is thank God I can now put these in the yard sale. Because it's been 3 years and I'm fucking tired of... I literally have all these speakers sitting out and all their boxes sitting empty for 3 years. Dead mouse, some chords. Ah! Bob Marley, Satisfy My Soul. Everything I hear on these, I'm fine with. I'm fine with it. I'm Zeus. I'm not allowed to be fine with fucking anything. You know how fucking annoying that is? Sorry about the F words, by the way. I would try to cut back, but I don't give a fuck. But literally, that's my job. Every day, everything I listen to, every song, every track is like, what's wrong with this? Every movie, I started doing with movies. I've been watching all those people reviewing the Star Wars, the Rise of Skywalker. And they find all the little details that are wrong. And I'm like, you know what? They're absolutely right. Why didn't I see that? And now when I watch movies or listen to music, I'm like, huh. This sounds like absolute shit. Wonder why they did it like this. And I don't hate any part. Fast forward a bit. Of the way these sound. They're a little bit, they actually could be considered a little bit sharp, but. That's perfect for a desk now. They give you easy to control. Controls, quality build, easy hookup, they have Bluetooth, they have a remote, even if it's a shiny black plastic remote. I love these speakers. I really do. They sound way bigger than they are. I've done a couple of speakers, those Fluence that I did with the 6.5 that were sealed, sounded like garbage. And these sound amazing in comparison to just about it. I mean, if I'm comparing them to RB42s, you should probably pay attention. Let me see, I could actually navigate to this. How do they get a treble that good out of a tweeter that looks so cheap? It's all DSP magic. It's all DSP magic. Because these on the side, these tone controls, they're slightly delayed. Which means if it was like a bass boost, if it was a potentiometer going to a part of the crossover and you were like, it would immediately work. And it doesn't immediately go there. If you go down and up, it sort of doesn't do anything and then you stop and then it goes. DSP is controlling everything. Edifier scientists are controlling everything. That's why these are fucking amazing. That's why the pluggables are fucking amazing. Because pluggables scientists, and I'm pretty confident that someone besides the pluggable team edited these to sound as good as they do. Dayton, they're not DSP correct anything. Dayton just happened to get away with putting the most badass 4-inch driver in here. It might even be the RB42 driver. That might be RB42, and that's MB42. And they slam it into a box that's like smaller than both those speakers. Well, volumetrically, it's probably similar to the RB42. Stick the cheapest amp Bluetooth combo in it. It's actually very, very acceptable. I want to put it higher on this list, but the edifiers and the pluggables, honestly, just the DSP kills it out here. And then these, which I'm not really like recommending because they're from a distance, from like, if I like stand way back here next to my dinner, from a distance, those are like, ooh, what are those? And then you get up close. Oh, you see Rockville. Oh, then you walk past them. Oh, never mind. So the Rockvilles are like they honestly sound not bad, but there's too many horror stories about them catching fire. Not these particular ones, but Rockville in general, that's like the word of the day. Dayton, can't go fucking wrong with Dayton. The only problem with Dayton is these two exist. I think these still put out the most low end, even though the box is smaller. That Excursion and that driver is just pounding. And I would love to give all these their own separate reviews, but I'm trying to keep you guys from having to watch 80 minutes of content. What am I saying? Four speakers would have been 25 minutes each. Like, wait, 100 minutes of content? So just enjoy this and let me get through it. The pluggables, DSP Magic, Kevlar driver, big ass soft dome. I was tempted to put them up instead of the edifiers, but I want to put those edifiers up because I think these are the ones that everyone wanted to see. No one was begging me in comments for months, Zeos, quick, do the pluggables. Yeah, no one did that. But everyone's like, Zeos, have you seen these edifiers? Have you seen edifier 1280s? Have you seen edifier 1700s? And I'm like, I have those. Well, here they fucking are, and they're amazing, and they sound great. And that's all you gotta know. And there is a sound demo, and I think it's those three. I think I just said fuck it with the Rockvilles. Didn't do their sound demo. Or I got them much later. I might have only had those a year. In Edifier we trust. I'd wear that t-shirt. If they sold that, if I got merch from Edifier, in Edifier we trust, because literally nothing they've sent me except for that one pair of headphones. That was sort of sketch, but literally every speaker product they send me, or I bought these, is fucking great. For the price, the build, like they have attention to detail that other speaker manufacturers just literally don't. I still have those, that 2.1, I still have it. It's not hooked up, but I still have it because I can't imagine pairing with it. This is Aloe Black Untitled 2 from Shine Through. I'm gonna end this now because it's just gonna keep going on and on and on. I am selling all of these though. These were cheap enough. I just don't want the boxes anymore. Please. Download that wallpaper in the description, and after you've done that, please join my Patreon or my Subscribestar and bid on these things. I'm gonna have all of them in the yard sale. All of them. All of them in this month's yard. What is today? Shit, it's the end of January today, so it's probably going to be the end of February. I got to keep them around for another month. Ah! Unless I push this video out tomorrow. No, I got to give it to the patrons and the Subscribestar people. The benefits of joining either one of those support tiers is you get to see all these reviews early. So if something is a hot product or something is brand new, you're paying for the benefit of seeing it early. That means you're probably not going to be out of stock if I'm the only one that's got the review out. So my patrons have that benefit. You get to ask me any questions you want through the messaging apps on both those services. Send me a message, I'll answer it. Usually I check once every week. Twice a week. I'm going to say twice a week. Enter in the yard sales. $5 a month gets you either on Subscribestar or on Patreon into the yard sales. You can buy any of these speakers along with other items in the yard sale. It's no minimum bid. And it's usually a blind silent auction. You just put whatever number you're willing to spend on something. Oh, those Enterprise are nice. $150 a little much. How about $78.33? If no one bids higher than you, you get an invoice at the end of 10 days. If you live in the continental United States, I ship it to you for free. You live, you know, in none of it, Canada, you pay half shipping. Because it's like $26 to get peanut butter up there. So that's the way that works. If having all this is not enough, $10 tier gets you into the behind-the-scenes private Telegram chat. You get to ask me any questions you want. I answer 16 times a day. People at me in there all the time. At Cios Pantera. Hey, I just bought this amp. You think this wire would pair with it? And I'm like, wires don't matter. And you're like, well, fuck you. And then... No, actually, the guy's great in there. Everyone helps each other out. Everyone messages me. I message them. I throw polls up behind the scenes. I just get something. They know. As soon as I get something, they know. As soon as I have my ideas on something, if you know I have something and you want to know what it's like, just ask me in that chat. You're paying me $10 a month. I'm going to tell you what I think about a thing. Like, there's just, it's just no waiting. Directly from my brain. So if that interests you, that's what that does. There are higher tiers, and those are for amazing people, and I haven't decided what I'm going to do for those people, but God bless for just, please pay for the cat, and, well, don't... Play for the cat. It's more appropriate. Pay for me to get new underwear sent to me. And don't forget to check out Hi-Fi Guides and Hi-Fi Guides Forum. Because that's really where this is all coming from. We started that right before we did Rocky Mountain Audio Fest. And it's grown significantly since the start. The actual Hi-Fi Guide site just had a repair done because it was doing weird things. But... There are currently, actually, I think I've already added these speakers to it. I'll add the pluggables and the Daytons to like the searchable list. So I was like, I want speakers, powered or not powered. Powered, what's your budget? $180. These will show up. Easy. And then the forum is obviously gonna have individualized posts, official posts for every product I review or DMS reviews or anything that comes out in general. Doesn't even have to be reviewed. Just I want people to have a focused place to talk about items. And that's what the Hi-Fi Guides forums are about. I'm done now. I hope this made sense. I've been put this off for 3 years. You think I'd have something to say like coherent? Nah. Coherence isn't my style. Style is my style. Anyway. Bob Marley, get up, stand up. Don't give up the fight. Don't give up, baby. Breathe some little time.